The Prep Sports Extra started in September of 1984. It was a five-minute show at the end of our 10 o'clock newscasts on football nights. Of course, it's much bigger and better now, some 38 plus years later. But in 1984, there was a player we spent a lot of time talking about. He's behind me. Cretin quarterback Steve Walsh, the first in a long line of great Raider QBs. Steve Walsh, Dan Scanlon, Chris Winkie, Chris Walsh, Steve's younger brother, Joe Mauer, Joe Springer, John Nance, and Mark Ault. That group spans 1984 to 2009, 25 years. Steve was a great player who went on to become a national champion and an NFL starter. But now, 38 years later, he's coming home to St. Paul. And what a homecoming it will be. This is what life has come full circle looks like. Steve Walsh, Cretin star quarterback in 1984, now coming home to coach the Raiders some 38 years later. It all started here on the football fields of St. Paul in the early 1980s. Walsh, number three, developed into a highly touted drop-back pro-style quarterback, one of the best in the country. So good, he earned a scholarship to play for coach Jimmy Johnson and the Miami Hurricanes in 1985. Thus the beginning of a long, successful football career, both college and the NFL, away from Minnesota and CDH, away but never forgotten.
A school I've had a relationship for, you know, for over 40 years. I mean, it was really, it wasn't just my 4 years of high school, it was 40 years that I've been involved. I've had, certainly my father went there, my younger brother, and then I had eight nieces and nephews go there, so. I've been involved, almost every year of my life since I've graduated.
Once a Raider, always a Raider. Steve will bring a mountain of experience to the job, from winning a college national championship for Miami in 1987 to surviving an interview with this handsome lad in 1989, prior to the NFL supplemental draft, to playing 11 years in the NFL with Dallas, New Orleans, Chicago, and three other teams, none of which were the Vikings. He coached high school in Florida and coached in the Canadian Football League until getting the Raiders job in December. Tell me a little bit about how this decision came about to end up at Cretin.
Well, first and foremost, we had made the decision to move from Florida back to Minnesota. And that was really driven because of my mom and dad. And they're in their 80s. And really just, we have a 10-year-old, my wife and I have a 10-year-old, and to be around grandma and grandpa and aunts and uncles and cousins, and it was really a decision to move back to Minnesota for family.
Speaking of family, we were there in 1989 when Steve's family watched his first NFL start with Dallas versus Green Bay at Lambeau Field.
Cross my fingers and say a few prayers.
A special day for this local football great and the family who loves him. So what about taking over the Cretin job, a program which opted in 2021 to drop down from Class 6A to 5A? Cretin is rich in football tradition, but it needs a boost.
What my feeling is, hey, it's been done before, it can be done again. Now the landscape is totally different.
Meaning numbers are down from feeder schools, and the assault on football in general has diminished numbers as well. But Walsh only cares about what he can control, and that starts with how he teaches the game to those young players.
My goal, if you want to play college football, great. I want to try to help you get there. But my ultimate goal is to give you such a great experience teaching you this game that someday you can teach your son and maybe coach your son and do a pretty decent job at it.
So get ready, Raiders. Class is in session starting mid-June. It should be fun.